Good afternoon, everyone. This is Josh from Palo Alto Networks, and I'm here to give you a quick walkthrough on how to integrate Cortex XSOAR with the ServiceNow Customer Service Management plugin that's available on that platform. One thing to note, I've seen this request from a couple of different customers, and when you look at the initial XSOAR integration, it doesn't look like that this plugin is supported based on the available commands. However, we have the generic create, update, and delete record commands, which can be used to manipulate records across a variety of tables that are installed by these plugins. Now, you have to understand how these tables are formatted, what's considered required data or required fields, and so on, but XSOAR does have the ability to manipulate that using the create, update, delete, or query record commands. To find out what tables you need to modify, you can go to the ServiceNow documentation. In this case, it shows you the tables that are installed by default with the CSM plugin. For this demo, I'm going to be focusing on the case table, so SN_customer_service_case. And with that, I am going to also show you within the ServiceNow platform where to find the columns that you'll need to reference within the XSOAR integration. So from here, I navigated to the table section under system definition. And as I showed before, I'm interested in the case table. So once I click in that, you get a list of all the different columns that are available in that table. And this is important because as you start executing commands within XSOAR, you need to know the specific column name that you're going to use as a value in one of the parameters you pass. So as an example, the assigned on column, that's the current label of the column, but what you want is the actual column name. So that's what you're going to pass into the XSOAR integration for ServiceNow using the create, update, delete, or query record commands. So if I hop over to my XSOAR instance, I've got a couple of commands queued and ready to go. So in this case, I'm going to create a new case record, and I'm going to use the short description field to provide a label of test from XSOAR, as well as add an initial comment of test comment one. One thing that's important to note is I have this surrounded by backticks. So right here for the table name, so I've got table name equals ServiceNow case and fields equals backtick, short description, comments, followed by a closing backtick. That way you capture any additional special characters that might need to be passed in without having to escape each and every one of them. So I'm going to run this command. You can see I get an associated record ID for that case that's now been created in ServiceNow. If I look over, refresh my page on ServiceNow, you can see the case has been created, as well as the comment that I've created or assigned to it. And last but not least, I'm going to go ahead and add one more comment to it using the update record command. In this case, I am referencing the variable servicenow.record.id, which points to this field here. And I'm going to add test comment too. So now that I pass that in, I can go back over to my record, and you can see test comment two has been appended. So this provides you just a quick demonstration on how to leverage the additional plugins that are available within the ServiceNow architecture, just by understanding which tables are installed as part of that plugin pack within the ServiceNow interface. I hope you found this video useful, and if there's anything else you would like to see content-wise, please let me know. Have a good day.